Configure anti-malware policies on the SRX. To continue, we now move back to the CLI of the SRX device and configure anti-malware policies. The steps required are 1. Name the policy and associate it with an inspection profile. In this example, I name the policy AAMW-policy and associate it with the default inspection profile. The default inspection profile is shipped with SkyATP. Other profiles can be configured in the web UI. 2. Configure an action to take. For the HTTP protocol, configure an action to take when the verdict threshold for a file has been reached. Note that no action is set in the CLI for the SMTP protocol. That is because the SMTP protocol action is set in the web UI. 3. Decide whether to log the action. Here we log both HTTP and SMTP traffic that passes through the AAMW-policy. 4. Enable the advanced anti-malware application policy in a firewall policy. Later in the video, we permit all traffic from the trust zone to the untrust zone and tell the SRX to analyze the traffic using the AAMW anti-malware policy. Configure security intelligence policies on SRX. Like the anti-malware policy, we need to configure security intelligence policy on the SRX CLI itself. Define the security intelligence profile at the Edit Services Security Intelligence hierarchy level and assign it a category. In this example, we set two security intelligence profiles, one called SecIntel_profile and one called IH_profile. Each profile gets assigned a security intelligence category. Only one category can be assigned per intelligence profile. Here we assign the CC or command and control category to the SecIntel profile and the infected hosts category to the IH profile. The infected hosts category makes use of the infected host feed. This feed lists the hosts that have been compromised and need to be quarantined from communicating with other devices. The feed is basically a list of IP addresses and their threat level. For example, 10.10.10.133 with a threat level of 7. You can configure security policies to take enforcement actions on the traffic to and from a host whose IP address is listed in the feed. The infected host feed is only downloaded to the SRX series device when the infected host profile is configured and enabled in a firewall policy. 2. Define rules for the profile and set the action. The rules determine the threat level to match, while the action determines what should be done with traffic that matches the rules. In this example, we set both profiles to take block and drop action for any traffic that matches threat levels 7 through 10. 3. Define the security intelligence policy and match it with the profile. Here we configure SecIntel-policy and match it with the CC and infected host profiles. Configure SSL proxy profile. For inspecting HTTPS traffic, a complete SSL proxy configuration must be added. This video does not show a complete configuration. For details regarding SSL proxy configuration, see the documentation link in the description. Configure firewall policy. To bring together and enable the anti-malware, security intelligence, and SSL proxy profiles, we enable each one within a firewall policy. Firewall policy is set to match from a source zone to a destination zone with a traffic type. The then stanza tells the SRX what to do when traffic matches the zone and traffic criteria. Here, we permit the traffic and tell the SRX to analyze the traffic through application services using the policies that we just created. The last part of CLI configuration for the SRX is to generate public-private key pairs, self-sign certificates, and install certificate authority certificates. The three commands shown create the needed configuration. Once committed, the configuration has all the needed elements for secure communication with SkyATP. For detailed configuration instructions, use the link in the description to view specific documentation.